Hello friends, welcome back. This is Himanshu Verma. Till now we have studied electromagnetic wave propagation in an unbounded medium. Unbounded medium means these electromagnetic waves will exist in a particular area and all receivers which are put in that particular area can receive those electromagnetic waves. Now in this lecture, we will study electromagnetic wave propagation in an bounded medium. Bounded mediums are used if we want point-to-point communication. For this type of communication, basically, three structures can be used. Number one is transmission line, number two is waveguides, and number three is optical fiber cables. In this lecture, we will study transmission lines. Transmission lines are basically a pair of conducting cables. Important transmission lines are number one parallel wire transmission cable, number two coaxial cable. In parallel wire transmission lines, two conducting cables are put parallel to each other, and in between the conducting cables, there is a dielectric medium. In this, one cable will have positive voltage and another cable will have negative voltage, and that's why these lines are known as balanced transmission line. In coaxial cable, there is a central conductor, and surrounding the central conductor, there is a dielectric medium, and surrounding the dielectric medium, there is a conducting wire mesh. In this structure, central cable have positive voltage and wire mesh will act as a ground, and that's why this cable is known as unbalanced transmission line. So always remember, parallel wire transmission lines are balanced transmission line and coaxial cable transmission lines are unbalanced transmission line. In this video, we will study a generalized behavior of transmission line, and for this we will take a parallel wire transmission line. Now this is a transmission line. This is conductor 1, this is conductor 2, and in between the conductors there is a dielectric medium. We can put a load impedance at this end and a AC voltage source at this end. Suppose source voltage is V and frequency is F. If we analyze this transmission line in a general way, then voltage across the load will be Vs, and voltage between these two points will also be Vs. Between these two points will also be Vs. Between these two points will also be Vs. Means we can say this complete wire will act as a short circuit, and voltage anywhere between these two points across the load will always be Vs. This whole wire will act as a short circuit only for DC voltage source or AC voltage source up to kilohertz frequency. If we increase the frequency beyond kilohertz range, then rate of change of amplitude of the signal becomes very high. And if we assume the signal propagates from source end to load end with maximum velocity, that is the velocity of light, then the signal will take time L upon C in reaching from source end to load end. Here L is the length of the transmission line. Now if we increase the frequency of source voltage, then time period of the signal reduces and reduces. If frequency becomes so high that capital T is very less than L upon C, in that case, the instantaneous voltage at this end will not be same the instantaneous voltage at load end. In fact, the voltage throughout the line will be different. Because voltage is different, that's why the current would also be different throughout the line. And because voltage and current are different, that's why the impedance seen into the line is different throughout the line. In other words, we can say the voltage and current would be a function of time as well as the location along the line, and the impedance seen into the line will be a function of location along the line. Due to this change in voltage and current configuration at high frequency throughout the line, we have to assume some passive elements throughout the line, and those passive elements should be such that they do not consume any power. Those passive elements are inductor and capacitor. So we can assume there is a inductor with inductance L Henry per meter throughout the line, and there would be a distributed capacitor with capacitance C farad per meter throughout the line. So this is the hypothetical configuration of a transmission line at high frequency. These inductors and capacitance are not put in transmission line actually, but at high frequency, because voltage, current and impedance become a function of location, that's why we assume transmission line behaves something this kind of configuration. So this is the modeled picture of transmission line at high frequency. This structure is for a lossless transmission line because inductor and capacitor do not consume any power, but practically the conducting wire would have some resistance and the dielectric which is placed in between these two wires will also have some conductivity. So we can say there will be a distributed resistance throughout the line and there will be a distributed conductance in between the conducting cables throughout the line. Resistance value can be R ohm per meter and conductance value can be G mho per meter. And now practically and transmission line can be shown R, L, G and C in this way at high frequency. These L, R, G and C are known as primary constants for the transmission line because these values will decide how voltage and current will be distributed throughout the line. Now we should also remember at high frequency voltage and current signals become voltage and current wave and these waves are just like electromagnetic wave. So we can make some analogy where voltage in transmission line is equivalent to electric field in electromagnetic wave propagation. Current I is equivalent to magnetic field H as electromagnetic wave propagates in the medium depending upon medium parameters such as sigma, mu and epsilon. In the similar way, voltage current wave propagates through the transmission line depending upon the transmission line primary constants such as R, L, G and C. So medium parameters in case of electromagnetic wave propagation was sigma, mu and epsilon, and in case of voltage current wave propagation those medium parameters are R, L, G and C. In case of electromagnetic wave propagation, the wave propagation constant gamma was defined by gamma is equal to alpha plus j beta, which was equal to j omega mu into sigma plus j omega epsilon under the root. So it was containing medium defining parameters sigma, mu and epsilon and of course frequency of electromagnetic wave also. In the similar way, for voltage current wave propagation constant is defined by gamma which is equal to alpha plus j beta and now it is equal to R plus j omega L into g plus j omega c under the root. So it is again depending upon medium defining parameters, that is R, L, G and C, and frequency of the voltage current wave. In case of electromagnetic wave propagation, the wave propagates in forward direction until and unless there is no medium change. Whenever a medium change occurs, then some of the power will get transmitted in the second medium and some power will reflected back into the first medium. So now there are two waves, one is forward going wave and second is reflected wave, are existing in medium 1. In the similar way, in voltage current wave, the wave will propagate in forward direction through the transmission line. But whenever there is a discontinuity in transmission line occur or some load impedance is encountered, then that act just like change in medium for voltage current wave. In that case, some voltage current wave power will be consumed by load and some power will be reflected back into the transmission line towards the source. So for this case, in transmission line, there are two voltage current wave existing. One is forward going wave, that is from source to load, and second is backward going wave, which is from load to source. And some of the power is consumed at load end. If we want to use transmission line practically, then our main motive is to reduce this reflected power and we want The maximum power should be consumed at load end. If all power is consumed by the load and there is no reflected power in the transmission line, then that condition is known as perfect match condition. And our motive is to achieve this condition. Now, as we know, in electromagnetic wave propagation, whenever wave is reflected back from media interface, then either of electric field or magnetic field will reverse its direction. Means there is always a phase difference of 180 degree in reflected electric field and magnetic field. In the similar way, when there is a reflection of voltage current wave at load end, then the reflected voltage and current have a phase difference of 180 degree. So if we write expression for voltage, which is a function of position and time, and suppose we take position in x direction, then it is a function of x comma t is equal to v plus, which is the amplitude of forward going wave, into e power minus gamma x. We know gamma is always negative, and because it is propagating in positive x direction, that's why we put x, into e power j omega t. This shows the forward moving wave is sinusoidal, varying with space as well as with time. Now in general case, we assume there is a reflected wave also, which would be written as v minus, which is the amplitude of reflected wave, into e power minus gamma into minus x, because the backward moving wave is propagating in negative x direction. After combining, this will become e power plus gamma x into sinusoidal time varying term, which is e power j omega t. So this is the general expression for voltage in a transmission line. This is the forward going wave and this is the backward moving wave. Here we can take e power j omega t common also, and we have to make sure that every term will have e power j omega t also, and therefore we do not write e power j omega t each time. So v x comma t can be written as v plus into e power minus gamma x plus v minus into e power plus gamma x, and e power j omega t is obviously present with these terms. In the similar way, we can write expression for current also, which is again a function of x comma t and is equal to I plus into e power minus gamma x minus I minus into e power plus gamma x. As I have already defined, there is a phase difference of 180 degree between reflected voltage and reflected current. Therefore, a negative sign is put here. In case of electromagnetic wave, as we know, in forward moving wave, the electric field and magnetic field have a relation where EI upon HI is equal to eta, where eta is the intrinsic impedance in medium 1. Also, in reflected wave, the same relation is followed, that is ER upon HR is equal to eta. In the similar way, in voltage current wave, the forward moving voltage current wave follow a relation where V plus upon I plus is equal to Z naught, where Z naught is known as characteristic impedance. Similarly, the same ratio is followed in reflected wave also, that is V minus upon I minus is equal to Z naught, where Z naught is characteristic impedance. In electromagnetic wave propagation, the eta was defined by medium parameters, where eta was equal to j omega mu divided by sigma plus j omega epsilon under the root. In the similar way, in voltage current wave, the characteristic impedance Z naught is also defined by medium parameters, which are now primary constants of transmission line, that is R, L, G and C. So Z naught is equal to R plus J omega L divided by G plus J omega C under the root. Here Z naught also have unit of ohm, just like intrinsic impedance has unit of ohm. So eta in electromagnetic wave propagation is equivalent to Z naught in voltage current wave propagation in transmission line. At high frequency, a transmission line can be represented by distributed inductance, resistance, capacitance, and conductance. If a transmission line is terminated by a load impedance ZL, then there will be forward going and reflected. Both kind of voltage and current wave will exist in the transmission line. In practical practice, our motive is to reduce the reflected voltage and current wave. It means the whole power should be consumed by the load, and there should not be any power which is reflected back to the source, because it can hamper the working of source. Because source is made for delivering the power, not for consuming the power. We can make a comparing chart for electromagnetic wave propagation and for voltage current wave propagation. In EM wave propagation, the medium defining parameters were sigma, mu, and epsilon. In voltage current wave propagation, the transmission line is the basic medium which has parameters R, L, G, and C, where R is the resistance per meter, L is the inductance per meter, G is the conductance per meter, and C is the farad per meter. These parameters are known as primary constant for transmission line. That's why they do not have absolute value. In fact, they have distributed value, which is measured with reference to unit distance. Gamma, which is a propagation constant, equal to alpha plus j beta, where alpha is the attenuation constant and beta is the phase constant. In electromagnetic wave propagation, the main loss in electromagnetic wave is due to conductivity of the medium. But in case of voltage current wave, the loss of wave is due to presence of power consuming elements which are resistance and conductance. The general value of gamma in case of electromagnetic wave propagation is given by j omega mu into sigma plus j omega epsilon under the root. But in case of voltage current wave, the general value of gamma is given by gamma is equal to R plus j omega L into G plus j omega C under the root. In case of electromagnetic wave propagation, eta, which is intrinsic impedance, which relates the forward moving electric field and magnetic field and reflected electric field and magnetic field by relation EI upon HI is equal to ER upon HR is equal to eta. In the similar manner, in voltage current wave, characteristic impedance Z0 relates the forward moving voltage and current and reflected voltage and current, that is V plus upon I plus is equal to V minus upon I minus is equal to Z0. The general formula for eta in electromagnetic wave propagation is eta equal to j omega mu divided by sigma plus j omega epsilon under the root. In voltage current wave, characteristic impedance Z0 is equal to R plus j omega L divided by G plus j omega C under the root. In an electromagnetic wave propagation, electric field E, which is a function of position and time, E x, t is equal to EI, which is the amplitude of forward moving wave, into e power minus gamma x, which shows wave is moving in positive x direction, into e power j omega t, which shows the wave is sinusoidally time varying, plus ER into e power plus gamma x, which shows the wave is propagating in negative x direction, into e power j omega t. In similar way, in voltage current wave, voltage V, which is a function of x, t, is equal to V plus into e power minus gamma x, which shows the wave is propagating in positive x direction, plus V minus into e power plus gamma x, which shows the wave is propagating in negative x direction, into e power j omega t, which shows both forward and reflected wave are sinusoidally time varying. In electromagnetic wave propagation, magnetic field H, function of x, t, is equal to hi into e power minus gamma x minus hr into e power plus gamma x. It is correspond to forward moving magnetic field. It is correspond to reflected magnetic field. This negative sign shows that the reflected electric field and reflected magnetic field will always has a phase difference of 180 degree. In voltage current wave, I, which is function of x, t, is equal to I plus into e power minus gamma x minus I minus e power plus gamma x into e power j omega t. Here negative sign shows that the reflected voltage and current will always have a phase difference of 180 degree. So friends, this was some basics of transmission line. We tried to set up an analogy between electromagnetic wave propagation and voltage current wave propagation. Friends, we stop here. In the next lecture, we will learn more about transmission line. Please like and share the video and subscribe the channel. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.